XFM News. On point. News on XFM. I'm Chris Tim. Presidential candidate General Henry Tumukunde has assured voters that no one will tamper with his victory in case they vote for him in the 2021 general elections. Tumukunde says that he has heard of a general fear among the voters wondering whether he will be able to protect the voters against rigging. He has also encouraged the voters to turn up in large numbers to cast their votes and protect it because this denies the said riggers an opportunity to tamper with it.
I get confidence that rigging on the 35,000 polling stations, even in Western Uganda, which is new, may not be so easy because that's the baseline of rigging. That's why I'm encouraging Ugandans to go and vote, because I think the numbers are leveling. Now, if they are leveling, although you're always worried about security people, my main question is, when you have all these polling stations properly manned, and we have correct records, even if you divided the police of Uganda in 35 polling stations, 1,000 polling stations, you only get two people. Are you sure those can facilitate rigging? So that's, for me, the level of comfort.
The Uganda Prison Service has confirmed that some of the rioters in the Free Bobi Wine riots, which claimed 54 lives, were ex-convicts. Over 1,000 people have been arrested by the Uganda police and charged with different offences, but 600 of them were remanded and convicted. The spokesperson of the Uganda Prison Service, Frank Baine, says that according to the research they have been carrying out, 29 were ex-convicts. He warned young people against such people who incite them to engage in riots to loot in the guise of political activism.
We decided to make a simple survey on the type of people they are bringing us, having been arrested because of riots. And it is very shocking, of those rioters arrested for rioting were actually ex-convicts. And with two prominent features, theft and robbery, more than 70% are on theft and robbery. What does this one mean? While activism is prominent, we also see a very high level of criminality in some of these activities. And that's why I want to urge the youth that when you are going to engage in some of these activities, please watch out. You must understand who you are dealing with.
Winnie Kiza, the national campaign coordinator for presidential candidate General Mugisha Muntu's Alliance for National Transformation, has decried the unfairness in the scientific elections. Kiza says that they have found it hard to access the different media houses in the places they have been campaigning because they are booked by the ruling NRM party and others are expensive. She adds that most radio stations are owned by NRM leaders who don't want to host the opposition candidates.
It's not an easy campaign. Majority of the candidates are using the radio stations, and there are no opposition people owning radio houses. So really going to an NRM person's radio, it's not easy. Sometimes if they give you the time, they will inflate the figures, the amount of money requested from you, and you see that it is too much, you can't afford. So you just chase yourself, but you know that they did it intentionally to stop you from using the radio.
On to world news, U.S. President-elect Joe Biden has chosen retired General Lloyd Austin as his defense secretary, U.S. media report. General Austin, age 67, will become the first African-American to lead the Pentagon. General Austin, who led the U.S. Central Command during the Obama administration, would need a congressional waiver as it is less than 7 years since he retired. Mr. Biden's reported decision comes 2 weeks after he announced other senior members of his national security team. In health, Japan plans to boost its stumbling birth rate by funding artificial intelligence matchmaking schemes to help residents find love. From next year, it will subsidize local governments already running or starting projects that use AI, that's artificial intelligence, to pair people up. Last year, the number of babies born in Japan fell below 865,000, a record low. The fast growing nation has long been searching for ways to reverse one of the world's lowest fertility rates. Boosting the use of AI tech is one of its latest efforts. Next year, the government plans to allocate local authorities about 2 billion yen, which is about 19 million US dollars, to boost the birth rate in Japan. In sports, Former Manchester City and Liverpool striker Mario Balotelli has signed for the Serie B side AC Monza until the end of the season. The 30-year-old Italian, who has been without a club since leaving Brescia this summer, trained with the Serie D side Fiorentina in November. Monza, who have ex-Tottenham midfielder Kevin Prince-Boateng in their squad, are ninth in the table in the second-tier Italian league. And that's the latest XFM News. XFM News.